Dear students, in previous lecture we discussed the continuous functions, those functions whose limit equals to the value of a function at a given point. We say that those functions are continuous at that point. That is, if we have a function f, then if a is the point in its domain, that is where this function is defined, then if at this point limit x tends to a f of x equals the value of the function at that point, we say that f is continuous functions. Now today we are going to discuss some special functions, how to check the given function is continuous at a point or over entire domain. Now if we consider a function f of x equals to 2x plus 3, we have to prove that this is continuous function. Means this is continuous function means if it is continuous at each and every point of its domain. You know that this 2x plus 3, it is simply a polynomial. You know that domain of the polynomial is R, that is whole set R, that is this polynomial or the polynomials are defined at each and every point of R. So we have to prove here this is continuous over R, means that this function is continuous at each and every point A, where A is real number. Now in order to prove that it is continuous, we have to prove that limit x tends to A, means A is arbitrarily real number, f of x is there, this 2x plus 3 equals to f of A. Now let A be arbitrarily real number, and you know that the limit of this polynomial is simply equals to the value of the function at this point, that is limit x tends to a f of x is simply 2a plus 3 equals to 2 of a plus 3, that is 2a plus 3. This is the limit, because limit of the polynomial is simply obtained by replacing or by putting the value of x in this polynomial. So it is this limit is 2a plus 3. Now the value of the function, that is f of a, because a is arbitrarily point, a is arbitrarily real number, is 2a plus 3, which implies that from first and second limit exists, that is limit x tends to a f of x is 2a plus 3, which simply equals to the value of the function at this point, that is 2a plus 3 here, which implies that from this, by the definition of continuous function, this f is continuous at point A. Now here this A means real number, this is arbitrarily real number, and the domain of this is R, which implies that this function, that is 2x plus 3 polynomial, linear polynomial, is continuous at each and every point. When it is continuous at each and every point, which implies that f is continuous function. Now second one is, we have to check the continuity of this function f of x equals to 2x plus 2, where x less or equals to 0, and 2x square, where when x greater than 0, we have to check its continuity at x equals to 0. Now firstly we will find the limit of this function at x equals to 0, because we have to check the continuity only at point x equals to 0. Now in order to find limit, we will find it's firstly the left limit. Now left limit at 0 is simply denoted by of this function f of x is simply denoted by limit x tends to 0 negative, minus f of x, this means that we are approaching to 0 from left side, that is if here it is the real axis, it is 0, we are approaching to 0 from this side. It is obtained by putting limit h tends to 0 f of 0 minus h. Now f of 0 minus h, when we substitute here, 0 minus is the point which is less than 0, because minus h is here positive, minus is negative, minus h is negative number. So for all the points which are less than or equals to 0, f of x is defined by 2x plus 2. So this means that f of 0 minus h is obtained by putting 0 minus h in place of x in 2x plus 2. That is here limit h tends to 0, 2 of 0 minus h plus 2 here. 2 of 0 minus h plus 2. That is limit h tends to 0 minus 2h plus 2. Here this minus 2h plus 2 is simply a polynomial in h. You know that the polynomial limit of the polynomial is simply replacing, you know, variable by the given number, that is by h equals to 0, that is minus 2 into 0 plus 2, which is simply 2. This means that left limit, that is limit x tends to 0 negative f of x of f of the, this given function is simply 2. Similarly, right limit equals to limit h tends to 0 positive f of x, that is we are approaching to 0, that is this here we have this real axis from this side. Now it is simply limit x tends to 0 positive f of x, that is limit h, which simply equals to limit h tends to 0 f of 0 plus h. F of 0 plus h is a point which is greater than 0, and for all the points which are greater than 0, the function is defined by 2x square, that is we have to put f of this 0 plus h in 2x square. Now f of 0 plus h is 2 of 0 plus h square. Now it is simply 2 of h square. Now 2h square is polynomial, so its limit is simply putting h equals to 0 in the given polynomial, that is in this polynomial, so its value is simply 0, which implies that left limit equals to 2 while as right limit equals to 0. So left limit equals not equals to 0, left limit not equals to right limit, which implies that limit does not exist. When limit does not exist, which implies that this function is never continuous at x equals to 0. So this means that this point x equals to 0 is the point of discontinuity, or we can simply say that at x equals to 0 there is break or the jump in the graph of this function. Now another function is f of x is x plus 1 x greater or equals to 0, 1 x less than 0. We have to check its continuity at x equals to 0. So we will firstly find its limit, that is left limit at 0 is simply limit x tends to 0 negative f of x, which is limit h tends to 0 f of 0 minus h. Now f of 0 minus h is same as f of minus h. Now for all the points which are less than 1, which are less than 0, the value of the function is 1, so this means that left limit is here 1. Similarly, right limit at 0 is limit x tends to 0 positive f of x, which is f of h. Now for all the points which are greater than 1, the function is defined by x plus 1, that is here f of h minus h plus 1. Now it is polynomial, so its limit is 1, which implies that left limit equals to right limit equals to 1. So limit exists. When limit exists, simply it is denoted by limit x tends to 0 f of x is 1. Now here limit exists. Also the value of the function at 0 is opened by putting x equals to 0 in this x plus 1, because function is defined by x plus 1 for all the points which are greater or equals to 0. So its value is simply x equals to f of 0 equals to 0 plus 1, that is 1. So this means that limit equals to the value of the function at 0. Hence we can say that this function is continuous at x equals to 0, that is this point is continuous, this point x equals to 0 is the continuity at this point, this function is continuous. So in this way you can check any function of this type to check, you know, the continuity at the point or over the entire domain. So thank you.